Deputy Paul Murphy.
At this stage, almost 1 million bills have been issued by Irish Water. At this stage, 592,000 have passed their pay-by date. And so can the Taoiseach please tell us how many water charges bills have been paid? What's the rate of payment? And more importantly, what is the rate of non-payment? Because I suspect there's a lot more non-payment than the government hoped, because otherwise you'd be out there shouting from the rooftops about how people were accepting these charges. And we also would not be faced with the bogeyman of legislation that is always just around the corner but never seems to arrive. On the 3rd of February, the Taoiseach told the Dáil that the legislation will be ready, and I quote, in the next couple of weeks. More than a couple of weeks later, on the 25th of March, he told the Dáil it will be introduced, and I quote, in a few weeks' time. A few weeks have passed, and yesterday he told the Dáil that it would be enacted before the House rises in July, and that's a quote. At this rate, Godot himself may ramble by before any legislation comes before the House. Is the delay deliberate, Taoiseach? Is it part of a dishonest plan, a plan simply designed to scare people and cynically timed to be at the same time as that bills are dropping? Is it the intention to create the impression that this will enable Irish Water to reach into people's wage packets or benefits or pensions and take their water charges, ably assisted by sections of the media? Because it's simply not true. It's clear that Irish Water will not, cannot be given any such power. For example, from the Law Reform Commission report, Irish Water is a company, they're not the revenue commissioners, they would have to go to court to seek attachment orders. And we've been here before. In the 1990s, people were taken to court for non-payment and were threatened with disconnection of their water services. There were protests at the courts. The courts were clogged up with non-payers. It proved massively politically embarrassing for the government. It did not break mass non-payment, and the water charges were abolished. Court action cannot break mass non-payment now either. The court services themselves have said they wouldn't be able to deal with the excessive burden. Perhaps that's the explanation for the haste with which Dennis O'Brien got down to the courts before they clog up with water charges protesters. And it would be political suicide to pursue any court cases before a general election. So the situation remains exactly as before. No penalties for non-payment until July of 2016, after the general election, and mass non-payment can sink the water charges. So what are the figures, Taoiseach? How many people have paid? How many haven't? What are the rates?
Taoiseach. Your speech is no different than the ones you've given before. You know as well as I do, if you want that detailed information, Irish Water will supply you with the information of the number of bills, the number of bills paid, and so on like that. You make a couple of points here, Deputy Murphy.
Please.
You say that in the 90s, people were threatened with disconnection. Well, government have listened very carefully to the genuine concerns of people all over the country, and government have legislated for the fact that there will be no cut-off of water, no cut-off of water supply. And as you know, as I said the other day, the government are moving to a much broader, more comprehensive, and I think a fairer system of dealing with civil debt arising from the work done by the Law Reform Commission a number of years ago, where people will not be sent to jail with the Victorian era being said goodbye to in that regard. So the charges, as you're aware, are €1.15 per week for a single person and €3 per week for two or more living in a household, and that the cap can still be beaten. And obviously those who register will be entitled to the support of €100 assistance towards that from the Department of Social Protection. Deputy, the position is that for this very modest contribution, people will receive high quality supply of water, which we would expect in a country as developed and as developing as ours in 2015. We can't go on, Deputy Murphy, with a system where thousands of people have had boiled water notices for years, where you have a grossly inferior wastewater sewage system in so many towns, where we've had 50% of the water to which people have contributed over the years, leaking away into the ground. And that's why it's necessary that Irish Water be a separate entity, able to borrow on the market to invest to fix those leaks and to invest both in terms of water supply and sewerage systems right across the country to bring us to the point of competency and service and standard that we should have been at for so many years. If you look at the record back along, we've had an investment of around 300 million over the years, which is about 50% of what we should be able to invest. We cannot do that given the scale of the finances of the country, and that's why it's necessary that Irish Water be set up. They're already finding out through the metering programme the scale of loss of water, which has been scandalous for 50 years. And obviously the opportunity now presents itself to bring our country its water system, its wastewater systems, its sewage treatment plants, right up to the very highest international standard. Sure. So I assume Irish Water would be happy to supply you with the details of bills that have been issued and bills paid.
Deputy Murphy.
Thank you. I asked a very simple question. I asked a question, one question, about what's the rates of payment. And the Taoiseach's answer is to say, go and ask Irish Water, as if it's got nothing to do with the government. Because the Taoiseach was not shy in boasting about puffed up, bloated Irish Water registration figures, where the same people are responsible, which is Irish Water. But a bit like Blue Peter, we prepared in advance, and we asked earlier Irish Water what the levels of payment were. And Irish Water said they wouldn't give us those figures, that they regard those figures, the levels of payment now, to be statistically insignificant, how many people have paid. 500,000 people, 500,000 bills, and somehow that will be statistically insignificant. Polls are done across the country with 1,000 people. So does the Taoiseach not know what the rates of payment are? Has Irish Water not informed him? Can the Taoiseach find that information, and can he please give it to the House? The other question, which he didn't mention the legislation, can you confirm that the legislation will require court cases? Can you allay the scaremongering that you have been deliberately engaged in, suggesting that Irish Water will be able to take them? And the point about the court cases before relating to disconnections, the point is that we've had court cases before. You were a TD. You were supporting the government parties at that stage. You were on the government benches. When you dragged people to court, you were met with protests and you couldn't break non-payment.
Thank you, Deputy. Thank you.
And the same situation is going to happen here. People have enough reasons.
Sorry, Deputy,
after 7 years
of
non-payment. So the two questions again, can you give us the figures or can you get the figures? And secondly, can you confirm that you're talking about court cases rather than direct deductions that Irish Water won't be able to directly deduct? And are you seriously considering any court cases in advance of a general election, in which case do you have other career prospects lined up?
Deputy Murphy, I know you're a deputy and you're elected by the people, and good luck to you. But sometimes I think that you feel that you're Julius Caesar and that you can dictate whatever you want to do yourself. Now, I'm not going to spoon feed you. So what I would advise you to do, Deputy Murphy, is I would advise you to toddle along to the AV room at 4 p.m. today, where Irish Water will be in
to give you
the answer to any questions that you want to ask them. And that's open to any deputy, including Deputy Paul Murphy. And you can go and ask them yourself, and don't be expecting me to spoon-feed you on that. Secondly, in respect of the legislation, the government expects to have legislated for this before the end of this session of the Dáil, and that the matter will be discussed here and in the committee rooms, as one would expect. And no doubt, Deputy Murphy, you would be fully entitled to contribute with your constructive suggestions to that debate. And I look forward to hearing you in your understanding of how important it is that we have proper water for people, proper water for business, and proper wastewater treatment plants throughout the country. So go along at 4 o'clock, participate in the democratic presentation which will be there for you, and when the bill comes into the House here, we look forward to your constructive suggestions.
Thank you. That completes leaders' questions for today.